Thank you so much. So, good morning, respected judges, and I'm going to present my study, Effect of Valsalva Maneuver on Ocular Blood Flow Parameters. I don't have any financial interest. We know that Valsalva Maneuver is being frequently performed during daily activities, including heavy weight lifting, vomiting, straining, forceful coughing, and sneezing. Now, when we see various phases of Valsalva maneuver, it has been seen that there is rise in intraocular pressure, and this is a recently published study in European Journal of Ophthalmology, which was a UBM study on 76 patients of primary angle closure glaucoma, where there was rise in intraocular pressure from 19 to 29, and there was narrowing of angle on UBM. Now, we know that vascular theory of glaucoma says that abnormal perfusion and subsequent ischemia of optic nerve head plays a major role in glaucometer's damage. And autoregulation is important for maintaining ocular perfusion pressure. Any change in ocular blood pressure due to increasing IOP, fluctuating blood pressure, resulting into decreased ocular perfusion pressure results into damage to retinal ganglion cells and subsequent glaucometer's optic neuropathy. So keeping these points in mind, when we searched the literature, we found that there was no study which has actually studied the ocular blood flow velocity in glaucoma patients and ocular hypertensive patients who were performing Valsalva maneuver. Therefore, this study was done with the aim to study the effect of Valsalva maneuver on ocular blood flow parameters by color Doppler in normal patients, patients of primary open angle glaucoma and ocular hypertensives. This was a cross-sectional study done at a tertiary care eye center. The ethics approval was done. Three cohorts of glaucoma patients were selected, POAG 32 in number, ocular hypertensives 27, and healthy control were 36 in number. Am I audible?
Request everybody else to please be on mute.
Yes. Yes, Dr. Sani, you are audible.
Thank you.
Audiovisual people, kindly
exclusion criteria. Exclusion criteria were these: advanced glaucoma were excluded. Detailed history and examination was done. Intraocular pressure was checked with Perkins handheld tonometer while patient was lying down in supine position pre and post and during Valsalva and post Valsalva. Gonioscopy Humphreys visual field was done. Valsalva maneuver was done by blowing into manometer till 40 millimeters of mercury for 15 seconds for each arterial measurement. Color Doppler was done on a M-turbo ultrasound system. And so this was the way we did color Doppler. We can see central retinal artery at anterior part of the optic nerve head, and short posterior ciliary arteries were seen just next to the optic nerve head. And this is the central retinal artery, short posterior ciliary artery, and ophthalmic artery in relation to the recti muscle. And then sample volume cursor was put at the blood flow. And we can see this graph. The peak of the graph is peak systolic velocity. The smallest possible raise is the end diastolic velocity, and resistivity index was automatically calculated by the machine. So these are the various arteries in which we study these three parameters. Now here we can see that when patient was not doing Valsalva, the peak systolic velocity was 11.8 millimeters of mercury. And as the patient started doing Valsalva, we can see the peak systolic velocity reduced to 9.88 centimeter per second. And this was done for central retinal artery, for ophthalmic artery, and for short posterior ciliary arteries. Now here we can see when Valsalva was being performed, this is the peak systolic velocity, which is 7.7. And as the Valsalva was released, it increased to 12.3. So statistical analysis was done by pair t-test to compare between the variables. Spearman correlation coefficient was also calculated. Now these are my results. We can see that maximum patients were in the age group of 41 to 50 years, and males were predominant. when we calculated the mean deviation, average of the mean deviation, it was minus 6.5 decibels in POAG, minus 1.14 in OHT, and in controls, it was minus 1.45. Now, these are the ocular blood flow parameters. We can see the mean ocular blood flow parameters were minimal for POAG patients in comparison to ocular hypertensive than control in all the three arteries. And similarly, end diastolic velocity was least for primary open angle glaucoma. Now, this is slightly busy looking table, but there were so many parameters for each artery. When we see that peak systolic velocity was seen to reduce significantly, the p-values were highly significant for all the three arteries in POAG patient. Similarly, end diastolic velocity also reduced to highly significant levels, and resistivity index increased to highly significant level during Valsalva in all the patients. In ocular hypertensives also, there was increase in peak systolic velocity and diastolic. There was decrease in peak systolic velocity and diastolic velocity and increase in resistivity index. And same were the parameters in controls also. When we try to calculate the Spearman correlation coefficient, we could find a negative correlation between the end diastolic velocity and short posterior ciliary velocity and mean deviation of the visual field. Now, the p-value was again significant for this correlation. Therefore, lesser was the blood flow velocity, more negative the mean deviation of the visual field was. So, in our study, we found that there were lower blood velocities as compared to control and ocular hypertensives. There was rise in intraocular pressure in all the groups to a significant level. Now, there was significant rise in resistivity index in all the arteries, suggesting that there is a reduced flow inside the arteries while doing Valsalva maneuver. Now, this was the only
study. Kindly conclude, time is up.
Yeah, this is a last slide. This was the only study which has studied pulsatile ocular blood flow in normal patients, but no study in glaucoma patients. To conclude, I will say that Valsalva-like maneuvers lead to increase in IOP and reduce ocular blood flow parameters. A negative correlation is found between end diastolic velocity and mean deviation. So recommendation was drawn that these kind of maneuvers should be avoided in the patients of pre-primary open angle glaucoma and ocular hypertension. Thank you so much for your kind attention.
Thank you, Dr. Shalini. Judges.